know that last year it's been estimated that between 50 and 60 million crowns were done in the USA by typical dentists here and there and everywhere? There are about 141,000 general dentists. There are a few thousand prosthodontists, and they're the people who do crowns. That is absolutely amazing. During the recession, we lost 4,000 labs. What happened? Because a lot of them were going toward milling, and a lot of the small labs could not afford scanners and millers, and they went belly up. And then, of course, the offshore laboratories have taken quite a bit of the marketplace. As much as 25% is going offshore, China primarily, but India, Costa Rica, you name it, Indonesia, Malaysia. And many dentists saw during the recession that veneers practically died. I love veneers. I was one of the pioneers in veneers. Let's look for a minute when crowns are better than veneers. Take a look at this contraindications for veneers. Veneers can be placed successfully on moderately discolored teeth. If they're really discolored, good luck. You show the gray or the brown or the black right through. Placing veneers on severely dark teeth is a very important contraindication. You're much better with crowns. Crowns solve this problem much better than veneers. Why? Because they have thickness to them. And many of them can have pigmentation in them and opacity in them, so they're better. Teeth with significant caries should be treated with crowns for several reasons. Number one, a lot of the tooth structure is gone. And number two, if you don't bury the margin of the crown below the gingiva, many, many crowns, supragingival in a caries-active patient, will rot out immediately. If the tooth lingual surfaces are worn through, veneers are not indicated. You can easily see that. If the lingual surface has been gouged right out, you're much better with crowns. Matching one single discolored endodontically treated tooth to adjacent teeth is almost impossible. In fact, I know very well that many of us have only had a few single anterior crowns that matched well in our career. That's true. What could you put on a tooth that is as dark as the one you're observing here? There are not very many things. Porcelain fused metal would cover it, but on the other hand, porcelain fused metal often loses its color over a short time because of glaze. Aluminous ceramic, most labs don't even know what that is. That's the most opaque of all the ceramics. An older product like Vita Inceram will do it. Thick zirconia will do it. What's thick? Full millimeter or more. They can block it. Can a veneer block that? I've had patients say, do a veneer for me. And I'll say, well, yeah, we'll do a bigger veneer. We'll wrap it around a little further. They don't know that's a crown, but that's one way to get around it. If a major change in occlusion is planned, crowns should be placed. A major change in occlusion, I've seen a lot of people try to do with veneers. And it's almost impossible because you get anatomy that's not adequate. Crowns are much better. How about bruxers, either grinding or clenching? That means they're either clenching down, they'll break anything you put in there, including your finger, or grinding left, right, left, right. Crowns are highly superior there. And right now, full zirconia crowns would be my choice right there. If the teeth are in facial version, I have fairly big front teeth, and my front teeth, if you veneered those, I would be Bucky Beaver. If they're in facial version, buck teeth, veneers usually make them look even more pronounced, and they're contraindicated. What am I really saying? I'm not trying to get you not to do veneers. I'm trying to get you to do veneers, and I'll have another one of these little communiques on when veneers are just about mandatory. Thanks for being with us. Join us next week. Don't forget.